Starting tomorrow, the Arizona Independent Redistricting Commission is taking public comment on its draft political maps. Last week, the commission approved a draft congressional district map, which led to much criticism, especially among Republicans. Here to provide analysis of the AIRC's preliminary congressional districts is Arizona Republic columnist Bob Robb and Barry Dill, a political consultant with First Strategic, a Phoenix-based communications and public affairs firm. Good to have you both here. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having us.
All right, Bob, thoughts on this draft map? We'll take the 40,000-foot view and then I guess stay up there for the most part because we're talking about the entire state of Arizona. What are your thoughts?
I think it's a very bad map, and it does favor Democrats, but not as much as Republicans are complaining about. The district had to tilt the status quo, either more towards the Republicans or more towards the Democrats, because we only got one additional congressional district, so you couldn't maintain the status quo. They have preserved, in my judgment, the same number of competitive districts, the same number of safe Republican districts, the same number of safe Democratic districts. What they did was to take what formerly was a competitive district in northeastern Arizona and make it a strongly leaning Democratic district. So basically what they did was, with the new district, made it strongly leaning Democratic, but it had to be one way or the other. The real problem is the way they did that and the communities of interest that they run roughshod over by picking up a large swath of Pinal County and throwing it into the western district, when it more naturally is a fit with the Eastern District, and then gerrymandering Maricopa County to create a competitive district that divides the suburban cities of Scottsdale, Chandler, and Mesa, which wasn't necessary.
Thoughts?
Well, first of all, I think that the commission has a really tough job based upon the demographics of the state, and I think this commission, its major focus is on competitiveness, whereas the commission 10 years ago was more on compactness and cultural boundaries and all that sort of thing. So, what I find amusing about this entire, it's not amusing, but what I find amusing about this entire debate is what I told you a couple weeks ago, which is that the Republican talking points about why they dislike this particular commission and this map are exactly the ones that my party used 10 years ago with a more sort of Republican-leaning commission.
You mentioned an emphasis on competitive districts. Republicans are saying there's too much of an emphasis on competition. Valid?
I reject the premise. I don't think you can explain this map by a primacy given to competitiveness, and you can look at the fate of Flagstaff, and I think illustrate that. Flagstaff is a democratically leaning area. It naturally could have fit with, geographically, with either the western rural district or the eastern rural district. It was placed at the request of Flagstaff leaders in the eastern rural district. That required this odd skirting around the top of Maricopa County and going far east to pick up parts of Pinal County.
And you're speaking of District 4, correct?
District 4. It required District 4 to pick up population in Pinal County, which doesn't naturally fit. Now, if Flagstaff had been put in the Western District 4 rather than the Eastern District 1, it would have made both 4 and 1 more competitive. The Western District would have become less Republican. The Eastern District would have become less Democratic.
Well, let me tell you one premise that Bob's making that I do not believe is true, is that the new district is, even though by voter registration it would appear to have grown more Democratic, but it does not take into account the traditional challenges that Navajo voters have actually going to the polls to vote, which include inclement weather, the fact that the federal elections and the tribal elections are not held either on the same day nor in the same locations, and it also does not take into account information we know that the biggest Navajo voter right now are young Navajos, and they tend to be spread out in Tempe going to college or at Tucson or in Palo Alto or someplace else. And so by an actual turnout percentage, it's really not all that much Democratic, and I would suggest is a swing district.
In 2010, which was a tidal wave election for Republicans,
absolutely,
Paul Garcer defeated Ann Kirkpatrick by about 6 percentage points. this map increases Democratic registration by 6 percentage points. So that it is potentially competitive only in a tidal wave Republican election. Year in, year out, it's going to be a relatively safe Democratic district if the Democrats field a decent candidate.
Well, there's another interesting saga, though, to the Flagstaff saga, because we do know that originally both sides were talking about splitting Flagstaff in half and having the East Flagstaff in the East District and West Flagstaff in the West District, thereby having two representatives, mm-hmm. in essence. And the city of Flagstaff is the one who turned that down.
Bob, I know that Democrats are saying, how can Republicans say this favors Democrats when they're, and I know you kind of debate the competitive aspect of this, but the way Democrats see it, there are four strong Republican districts, two strong, mostly voter rights districts favoring Democrats, and they see three competitive. They would love to see four competitive districts because they think that even makes it closer. It still favors Republicans over Democrats, 3-2.
The Voting Rights Act pretty much precludes three truly competitive districts. You just don't have enough Democratic population to create three competitive districts. And I do believe that Republicans' protest over the political impact of the map is overstated. As I said, you're currently four Republican, two Democrat, two competitive districts. You now will be four Republican, two Democrat, two competitive, and one strongly leaning Democrat, in my view. It had to either be leaning Democrat or leading Republican. The problem with the map isn't its political results. It's the way it achieves them by running roughshod over natural political boundaries and communities of interest.
And the Democrats don't necessarily like what they got, which kind of confuses the whole issue about why the Republicans are so upset. Democrats went into this asking for, wanting four competitive districts. They also wanted only one border district instead of what they produce now. They have three. So Democrats aren't getting everything that they wanted either, which suggests to me that if everyone's upset, it's probably okay.
The idea, though, of communities of interest and geographic boundaries just being pretty much run roughshod as opposed to competition or other aspects of the map, or even things that aren't constitutionally required to be an aspect of the map, do they get short shrift here?
Well, I think again, as I said earlier, to the subject of competitiveness as a primary concern over some of those other things, you can make that case. That new district is a big sprawling. It goes from the Mexican border to the new Mexican border all the way to Utah and then to the mouth of the Grand Canyon.
We're looking at it right now in blue. I mean, that's bigger than half the states in America.
It is gargantuan. But I think, Bob brought up a really good point, is that as less Republicans and less Democrats fill the voter registration rolls because of independence, the demographics of the state are changing, and so the challenge to make things as competitive as possible is great.
Will the map change? Should the map change?
I definitely think the map should change. Whether the map will change, I think, voluntarily by the commission, will depend upon the amount of political leaders of these areas that are sort of thrown in with unlikely company, and the extent to which they show up at these hearings and how vigorously they protest their treatment under this map.
And my view is that the Republicans are trying to bully or at least urge a big turnout, make a lot of noise in order to try to force the commission to make changes. But I quit learning to make predictions after the OJ trial, so I would have no idea whether they would change or not.
All right. Well, thank you both. It's a interesting map. It certainly has some curiosities to it, but I guess that kind of goes with the territory. Good to have you both here. Thanks for joining us.